Hi students, welcome to Justin NCERT Solutions. In this video, we are going to see 600 Maths Chapter 3 Exercise 3.3 Second Question. Here, we are going to find the following numbers. What are the numbers are divisible by 4 and 8? Now, the first question option A, we are going to check it whether the number is divisible by 4 and divisible by 8. First, we are going to check it for divisible by 4. According to the divisibility rule, if last two digits are divisible by 4, then this number is divisible by 4. Now we are going to check it for divisibility 4. 72. In 7 we have 1 4 is there, 1 4 is 4, remaining 3, 32. 8 4s are 32, remainder 0. Therefore, this 572 is divisible by 4. So when we are dividing 572, is divisible by 4. Next we are going to check it for divisible by 8. If last 3 digits are divisible by 8, that number is divisible by 8 according to the divisibility test by 8. Here we have only 3 digits, so we are going to divide this 572 divided by 8. In 57, 8 sevens are 56, remaining 1, so remaining 2. In 12 we have 1 8 is 8, remaining 4, remaining we are getting 4. Therefore 572 is not divisible by 8. So 572 is divisible by 4, but 572 is not divisible by 8. That is option A. Next we are going to solve option B. According to the divisibility test, if last two digits are divisible by 4, that number is divisible by 4. Now we are going to check it for last two digits, 52 divided by 4. In 5 we have only 1 4 is there, 1 4 is 4, remaining 1. Then we have taken 12, 2, now 12, 3 4s are 12, remaining 0. So this number is divisible by 4. Next we are going to check it for 8, last 3 digits, 352 divided by 8. In 3 we don't have 8, so we have taken 35. In 35, 8 4s are 32, remaining 3. So these 2 we have taken. 8 4s are 32, remaining 0. Therefore, the given number 726,352 is divisible by 4 and 8 also. So the given number 726,352 is divisible by both 4 and 8. Next, option C. Option C, 5500. Here last two digits are 0. If last two digits are 0, we don't have any problem. That number is divisible by 4. We can say that last two digits are 0. Therefore, this number is divisible by 0. We can check it. We will take it by 3 digits because last 2 digits are 0. If last 2 digits are 0 is coming when we are dividing by 4, definitely the number is divisible by 4. Now I will show the proof also. 500, we are going to divide it by 4. In 5, we have only 1 4 is there, remaining 1. So we have taken this 0. 2 4s are 8, remaining 2. So we have taken this 0. 5 4s are 20, remaining 0. So this number is divisible by 4. Next we are going to check it. Last 3 digits are divisible by 8 means the entire number is divisible by 8. So 500 we are going to divide it by 8. In 50, how many 8s are there? 8 6s are. 6 8s are 48. Remaining 2, 20. 2 8s are 16. Remaining 4. Remaining 4 is coming. So this is not divisible by 8. Therefore, 5500 is divisible by 4 and it is not divisible by 8. Next we are going to check it, option D. 6000 is given. We will check it. Here last two digits are 0. So already we said that if last two digits are 0, the number is divisible by 4. And next also last three digits are 0. If last three digits are 0 means that number is divisible by 8 also. Now we will see that example. We will see the proof. Is there, we are going to divide it by 4. In 6 we have 1 4 is there, remaining 2. 20, in 20 we have 5 4s are 20, remaining we have 0 only. So we are adding this to 0 here, 1500. So this number is divisible by 4. Next we are going to check it for 8, divisibility for 8. In 6 we don't have any other 8, so we are taking 60. 8 7s are 56. Remaining 4. This 0 we have taken. 8 5s are 40. Remaining 0. But with here we have another one 0. So we added here. So 750 is quotient. Now therefore 6000 is divisible by both 4 and 8. So 6000 is divisible by both 4 and 8. Next number, 12159. Last two digits 59. We will check it. Divide by 4. In 5 we have only 1 4 is there, remaining 1. So now 19. In 19 we have 4 4s are 16. Remaining 3. Remaining 3 is coming. So this number is not divisible by 4. Next for 8. Last 3 digits 159. Divide by 8. In 15 we have only 1 8 is there, remaining 7, 9. In 79, 8 9s are 72, remaining 7. So remainder 7 is coming. Therefore 12159 is not divisible by 4 and 8. 4 and 8 also will not divide the given number. Next, option F. 14560. According to the divisibility rule, for 4 we are going to take the first two digits, last two digits, dividing by 4. In 60, 1 4 is there, remaining 2, 20, 5 4s are 20. So the given number is divisible by 4. Next we are going to check it for divisibility by 8. Last 3 digits 560. We are dividing by 8. In 56, 8 7s are 56. Remaining 0, and here one 0, so we are adding 0 here. So both numbers are divisible by, sorry, the given number is divisible by both 4 and 8. Therefore, 14,560 is divisible by both 4 and 8. Next, we are going to solve option G and H. Next, option G, 21,084. We are going to check in last two digits. 84 dividing by 4, 2 4s are 8, remaining 0, and this 4 you have taken, 1 4 is 4, remaining 0. So the given number is divisible by 4. Next we are going to check it last 3 digits. And here when we are taking last 3 digits, we have only 84. So we are going to check it whether the number is divisible by 84. Here last 3 digits, here we have 0, therefore we are taking only 84. This 84 is not divisible by 8. 1 8 is 8, remaining 0, and 4 is there, we cannot divide this 4 by 8. Therefore, 21,084 is divisible by 4 and not divisible by 8. Next, option H. Last two digits we have to check it for divisibility by 4. So 72 we are going to check it, divide by 4. In 7, 1 4 is there, 1 4 is 4, remaining 3, 32 we have taken, 8 4s are 32, remaining 0. So this number is divisible by 4. Next we are going to check it for 8. Last 3 digits we have to take, but last two, the 3 digits we have 0 in the third digit. So we are going to take only the 2 digits, 72. 8 9s are 72, remaining 0. So the given number is divisible by, therefore given number is divisible by 4 and 8. So option H is divisible by both 4 and 8. Next, option I. Option I, 1700. Here last two digits are 0, so we don't have any problem. We can say that this number is divisible by 4. We will see the proof also. 700. In 7 we have 1 4 is there, remaining 3, 30 we have taken. 7 4s are 28, remaining 2, 20. 5 4s are 20. So the given number is divisible by 4. Next, last 3 digits we are going to check it for 8. In 7 we have, we cannot divide by 8, so we are taking 70. In 70, 8 8s are 64, remaining 6. 60 is coming. 8 7s are 56, remaining 4. It is not divisible by 8, therefore 1700 is divisible by 4 and not divisible by 8. Therefore 1700 is divisible by 4 and not divisible by 8. Next, last sum, option J, 2150. First we are going to take last two digits dividing by 4. In 50 we have only 1 4 is there, remaining 1, 10, in 10 we have 2 4s are 8, remaining 2. So when we are getting remaining 2, this number is not divisible by 4. Next we are going to take last 3 digits, 150, we are going to check it for 8. In 15 we have only 18 is there, remaining 7, so now we are taking 70, 8 8s are 60, 4, remaining 6. So here also remaining is coming, therefore 2150 is not divisible by 4 and 8. So 2150 is not divisible by both 4 and 8. That's all students. Kindly give your suggestions in the comments box. Share this video to your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you.